The family of an American who has been jailed in Dubai is pressing the State Department to help bring him home. The man is from Minnesota. He thought he was creating a funny online video. As Don Dela reports, the satire came at a serious price.
For the last 7 years, 29-year-old Shazane Shez Kasim, an American from Woodbury, Minnesota, has been working as a business consultant in Dubai.
You know, in Dubai, especially, supper is very dangerous. So we had to make our own martial arts.
But after Kasim posted this parody on YouTube last year, mocking gangster youth in the Gulf City, authorities in the United Arab Emirates arrested and interrogated him. He's been held in a maximum security prison since April.
Shez is in jail for making a video, and we call for his human rights to be recognized and that he be released.
On Monday, a court sentenced Kasim and seven others to up to a year in prison for endangering the state's national security by producing the video.
The Na'al is a very important weapon.
The video spoofs martial arts training, including using shoes as the ultimate weapon.
They run away, they're scared, because nobody mess with us. We are sent to a combat school.
Kasim was born in Sri Lanka and graduated from the University of Minnesota in 2006. At the beginning of the clip, they included a disclaimer, saying the production was fictional and meant no offense. In a statement Monday, Kasim's family said, "This is so painful and unfair, we can hardly believe it," adding, "It's obvious the intent and content of the video is not meant to cause harm." Yet Shez is still in jail.
We are submitting this in support of Shez.
On the website funnyordie.com, comedians have expressed their support.
Basically, Dubai, if you want to be viewed as an international place, destination, don't put people in jail for making silly videos.
I guess it's your most dangerous weapon.
After the verdict, the U.S. State Department told CBS News that Mr. Kasim's conviction is contrary to his rights to freedom of opinion and expression, and that they are trying to determine what impact time already served may have on his sentence. For CBS This Morning, Don Dela, New York.